In this video, I will be walking through the process of upgrading to Avalanche 6.2.2 from Avalanche 5.3. To prepare for the upgrade, I ran a deployment in Avalanche 5.3 to make sure my servers and devices are up to date, and created a backup of my Avalanche database and software packages. The operating system that I had 5.3 running on is not supported by 6.2, so I will be installing Avalanche on a new system running a supported operating system. To see if you need to upgrade to a new system, follow the link in the description to see the Avalanche 6.2 system requirements. Because I am moving systems, I also configured my Postgres database to allow remote access, and on my new system, installed and configured Microsoft SQL Server 2016. Instructions on how to do all of these things can be found through the links in the description. I also made sure I know the password from my AMC admin account. LDAP users will not be migrated. Instead, the first time you sign into Avalanche 6.2.2 with LDAP credentials, a new user with no permissions will be created. If you need help recovering the password for AMC admin, contact Avanti support. Let's start the upgrade. Begin by launching the Avalanche 6.2.2 installer. Select a language. The pre-install checklist link has information about system requirements, what ports Avalanche uses, and certificates. If you haven't already, it's a good idea to review this before installation to make sure things go smoothly. Read and accept the license agreement. Here you can choose the install destination by clicking Browse. Select Upgrade and the database type that you were using for Avalanche 5.3. If you used what was included with Avalanche and didn't install a database separately, select the Postgres option. Select which components you want installed on this computer. You can either install all of the components on one computer, which is best if you plan on only managing one location, or distribute the components over multiple systems, which is best if you plan on managing multiple locations and will need to manage memory and processing power demands. Enter the hostname or IP address of the machine where your Postgres database is stored and enter the username and password for it. Now enter the hostname and credentials for the new SQL Server database. The username and password were set during the Microsoft SQL Server installation process. When the installer asks for permission to create an Avalanche database and an Avastats database, click Yes. Here you can set the location for the shortcut. Click Next to accept the configuration information for the central web file server. This page summarizes what the installer will do during the update process. Click Next to begin the installation. If an earlier version of Avalanche was on this system, the 6.2 installer will open the uninstaller for the old version. Click Next, then Yes to remove the earlier version, then click Finish to continue the 6.2 install. Avalanche 6.2.2 has changed the way the Avalanche database is encrypted. This means you must back up your encryption key separately from the database. I will go over how to back up the key later in this video. This page links to a document online that has more details. Acknowledge that you have read the information and know that you need to back up the encryption key, then click Next. Click Finish to complete the Avalanche 6.2.2 installation. Now let's go back to the encryption key. Like I said, encryption works differently in Avalanche 6.2.2. Your encryption key will now be stored outside of the database and must be backed up separately. To do this, find the avalanche.ikey file in the Avalanche directory and copy it to a secure location separate from the database. Refer to your company's secure file policy when determining this location. Now I can open the Avalanche console from the Start menu or by opening a web browser and typing the address of the computer :8080/avalancheweb in the address bar. In the navigation tree, server locations have been converted into regions, and group locations have been converted into folders. The mobile device server that was upgraded has been moved to the unassigned server locations region, so I will need to move it to the region where it belongs. Devices won't show up in the inventory until they check into the new server. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions, see the online help at help.avanti.com or visit the Avanti community.